Greetings, everyone. I hope that you're all feeling positive and optimistic and shielding yourself from all the craziness that's happening in the world right now. It's a lot of negativity out there, a lot of darkness, but it's up to us to create our reality, right? So making sure that we're waking up, starting our day with gratitude that always shifts the energy immediately. Telling your loved ones that you love them as often as you can, telling yourself that you love yourself as often as you can. You know, it's, even though there is a lot of chaos in the world, we are on the light side. So, you know, if it's a battle between good and evil and light and dark, remember what side that you're on. And part of you fulfilling that light side and abiding by that and contributing and perpetuating the light is by making sure that we have a light heart and that we, again, are just coming from a place of gratitude. Little things like that is what keeps our vibrations up high. So I hope that the videos that I'm sharing with you, you know, with, you know, whether it's diet and just being mindful, I hope that I'm in some way contributing to bringing positivity into your life in some way. That is my whole intention, is to help inspire, to uplift us so that we could just live wholesome lives and live the lives that we were designed to live. So this particular weekly womb wisdom is about meal planning, and this is something that's come up a lot. I led a 7-day detox, sugar detox, a couple of weeks ago, and that was one of the things that we talked about. So if you want to eat healthy, if you want to lose weight, if you want to have more energy, if you want to have stable moods, if you want to have a healthy sex life, if you just want to feel good in your body, you have to eat healthy, right? And so oftentimes you say, well, I don't have enough time to make dinner for myself, you know? But I beg to differ, because we always find time for social media, right? We always find time to do those selfies, to find those memes, and sometimes it takes a while to go on Google Image to find memes. So if we can take time out to spend a half an hour on social media, we can take time out to prioritize and do meal planning once a week. It saves you money. You know where your food's coming from. You're putting your own energy into your food. If you meal prep and have everything ready to go, you are less prone to eat out. You're less prone to emotionally eat on food that's unhealthy. And again, like I said, you save money. It's a win-win situation. And of course, we want to be able to treat ourselves to eating out every now and then. There's nothing wrong with that. But if you want to like get into a sustainable, consistent eating pattern, meal planning is the way to go. Okay, so I'm going to share with you what I do, and then of course you can, you know, see what works for you. So for me, Saturday mornings is the farmer's market in my town, which is San Leandro. It's from 8 until 1 o'clock in the morning. The last thing I want to do on a Saturday morning is get out of bed, because I'm struggling with my husband. He's really cute and warm, and I want to stay in bed and just sleep in with him. But I know that if I'm going to set myself up for success, then I know that I need to get up and get to the farmer's market and do all my groceries and get everything ready for the week. It's just, especially again, if you have a busy schedule, those little, you know, you have a limited windows of opportunity in order to take the time out to do your meal prepping. So it takes me a good 3 to 4 hours within my Saturday to get up, go to the farmer's market. If I need to get like butters, like nut butters and stuff like that, or like things in bulk, I'll either go to Whole Foods or Trader Joe's. And I get home, you know, rinse all my vegetables, get everything cut up and organized and ready to go. And so another thing that I do that I highly suggest is I also, like certainly before I go to the grocery store, I'll research a recipe. Because that's another thing too, that when it comes to eating healthy, if we keep eating the same thing over and over again, we get bored. And then we find that even if we may make a big batch of it, we're not into it, so we don't eat it. So our food waste food, we waste money, and then again, you kind of set yourself up for wanting to have something that's more immediate, which could be, you know, processed foods or going to eat out. So like every, you know, week or two, I'll research a recipe, and then, you know, so I know everything that I need to get before I go to the grocery store. So one of the things that's gonna be your friend when it comes to meal planning are these gallon Ziploc bags. Okay, so with me, I like to have a green juice, if not every day, every other day during the week. So I'll have like seven of these, with every single ingredient I need for my juice. If I'm gonna make a salad, I'll make a gigantic size salad. And I'll put a Ziploc or Saran wrap over the bowl. If I make, for an example, a few weeks ago, I made vegan lasagna, which was really incredible. What I loved about that vegan lasagna is that since it's using a lot of nuts for the cheese, it's really heavy. So you just need a small little square of serving, and that filled me up. And that batch that I made lasted pretty much a week and a half. So you want to also look for recipes where you can make an abundance of it. And you can put in a Ziploc bag and you can just get up in the morning and warm it up and you're good to go. So I always prep a breakfast, a lunch, a dinner, and a snack. And for snacks, it could be anything like trail mix, or I'll make a big batch of popcorn and I'll use Bragg's amino acids and nutritional yeast. So maybe I'll put some almonds in it and I'll put that in a gigantic Ziploc bag. So all I have to do is just get the portion that I need each day to take with me when I go out into the world, So meal planning is everything. And another benefit that you get from it is that your own energy is going into it. You know where it's coming from, and it forces you to be creative in your kitchen. Create a nice sacred space when you're in your kitchen. Have some really good music going. Light a candle. Open up the curtains and let the sun in. It's just a really, it's a type of self-care. It's a type of self-care, for you to be able to make your own food. So yeah. So this is a really short video. So meal planning. Give it a shot. Like I said, it takes about maybe 3, sometimes maybe 4 hours in your day, depending on what you're making. But then once everything's ready to go, and then during the week, all you need to do is grab what you need, warm it up, or put it in your, your lunch pail, whatever you used when you're, going to work. And then it literally, it takes me about 15 minutes every morning to get all my stuff in order to go to work, because of the meal planning. So give that a shot. Again, Ziploc bags, the gallon Ziploc bags would be your best friend. You can get the smaller ones, like the sandwich size for like your snacks for the week. Again, it saves you money. It gives you an opportunity to research just different recipes. You can be more creative in the kitchen. And it's just the way to go. And also, I highly, highly stress looking into shopping at your farmers markets if you don't do that already. I swear that last weekend when I went grocery shopping, I spent $27 on produce that lasts me for an entire week, and it was all organic on top of that, and that included my juice, it included my salad, and it included my green vegetables as my side dish for my dinner during the week. So look into farmers market. You save so much money. You're supporting local farmers. It's close to the ecosystem. It helps support the environment because you're not supporting the transportation costs with all the, the gas and all the carbon dioxide that's going into the environment from the traveling of the trucks. Less energy, less different hands it's being touched on it. It's going pretty much straight from the farm to your table. So there's many, many benefits with shopping at farmers markets. So yes, I hope you give this a shot. Again, it's really the only way to have a sustainable, healthy diet is meal planning, period. So if feel free to hit me up in the inbox if you have any questions. I'm always putting out recipes for vegan recipes, so feel free to check that out. And yeah, so there you have it. That's our weekly womb wisdom for this week. Meal planning. Give it a shot. Set yourself up for success. Okay, everyone, peace and love, and I will see you all next week. Okay, take care.